Coach, whenever you're ready.
Okay, first of all, happy for our team. Good win. Obviously, anytime you shut an opponent out, that's really something in college football. Our defense did that. Thought our offense did a good job on the ground and through the air. You know, the first half, it was miserable, the weather was, and I think our guys handled that well. We didn't have any turnovers. We got the second half. We were able to play a lot of different people. It really didn't get sloppy. I think our guys played good, clean football. Got a chance for Cord Sandberg to really go in there and get his first, true opportunities. I thought he did a very good job with two touchdowns. He managed the offense well, and that was really good to see. Really appreciate our crowd, especially with the weather like it was and the forecast. And really appreciate our band too. I think a lot of bands would have went home. Ours didn't, and they were a big factor, in the game, and really appreciate them. But overall, really happy with the way that we played, on to next week. Questions?
Coach, how important was it to get some good positive vibes going the next week?
Yeah, I think it was very important. And I think too, anytime you play in adverse conditions right there, I think that's very good too. We practice out in that stuff, a couple times in the last month, but there's nothing like the real thing. To go out there and, handle the conditions and really to protect the football with no turnovers. And there was a lot of different people that touched the ball. So I think that is that's a really good plus, carrying forward too.
Is Mike Horton going to be okay?
Yeah, Mike was a guy that got a little banged up last week and just chose to hold him out. We think he's going to be fine next week.
And J.J. Wilson?
Yeah, J.J. Wilson, he had a little minor thing that happened. We chose to hold him out, too. We feel pretty certain that he'll be back next week, too.
What was the decision behind going with Caleb Kim there, right guard, instead of Broderick Hammer?
Yeah, Broderick's been playing more right tackle. And Caleb's kind of been that guy that, with Nick, they were kind of the third guards, with that. So that was just kind of a natural thing for us. I think Caleb did a good job, when he was in.
You mentioned the weather. Just how happy were you with how Bo handled that, the early start?
Yeah, I was real happy because, like I said, we were trying to keep the balls dry in there, and I know we hit the wheel route and the ball kind of stayed up, but the ball was soaking wet. And I think anytime you get a chance to experience that, and it's always also good for your ball boys too, about when to get a ball, dry ball in best you can. But it was there for a while. It was real interesting weather-wise.
Yes, can you talk about your backup defense? They look like they play pretty well.
I think so too, and I think they had two fourth down stops or whatever. And we were playing everybody, and so I think anytime you can go in there. And like I said, I was real encouraged at halftime. We knew we were going to get a chance to play some other guys, and we just said, I don't want it to get sloppy. Let's make sure we play good, clean football. And I really think they did that. Played extremely hard. And it was really good to get some other guys, some reps and get them out there and play. So I think that'll help us, for the future with that too.
How important was that second quarter then to kind of to open it up a little bit to be able to prepare to play those guys?
Yeah. That was really the plan. We really wanted to get to halftime and get a chance to play other people. And for the most part, we did that. I think we hung in there with our ones, one series or whatever, and then we got a chance to put our twos in there. And, of course, at the end, really our threes, and got a chance to let those guys play.
What did you see on that third quarter play when Jamie got ejected?
Anytime you get a guy ejected, it's tough. It's tough, especially with the game we got next week.
I guess that's the first time Cord's thrown passes a lot in the game since 2012. How do you think he handled that part?
I think he did really well. He's been practicing well. The first 6-7 games, he was the number three quarterback, really didn't get any practice reps except in individual. So the last 4 weeks, he's got the number two reps. And what we tried to do is go the ones and twos with equal reps to try to accelerate, him. But there's nothing like the real thing. And I think he performed very well on the first touchdown. The throw to Zach was a really good throw. And then, of course, he had the beater to the field. I thought it was a great throw. And then, of course, that was triple option down there going in that he threw the second touchdown. But I thought he managed everything well, communicated everything well.
What do you think? Moving forward, Coach, this coming week, what does it mean to you? Talk about what lay ahead for this program and this team.
Oh, we're excited. We've got the Iron Bowl at home. It's as good as it gets.
What did you think of Bo Nix's decision-making today?
I thought he did some good things. You know, we were really close on the deep one. You know, I think to Cedric, it was really close, and it finally let up a little bit, so we had a chance to throw it down the field. But you know, I thought he did some good things.
For that throw to the Joiner there, I mean, it looked similar to the play against Georgia, even though I don't think they're in the same formation.
Yeah, no, that was a play that I think the last time we ran that was against Oregon. And Joyner kind of got knocked down on that, and it's just a play we've been saving for that type of situation. And I think it was a third down, if I remember, third down and goal from the six. And you know, they were playing man, and he kind of got lost coming out of the backfield. So that was a good play.
Going into this regular season finale, just how much progress have you seen from Bo, even to the point, you know, going back to when he first came in and rolling early?
I think each week, I think you just see him growing. And improving, but that's to be expected. I mean, you know, we're in game 12 coming up. He started 11 games, and so he should be more comfortable, and I feel like he is.
What are you seeing from Anders Carlson? He's missed several field goals.
Well, the one got blocked, you know, and I think it was more of a snap and a hold. It was raining like crazy. Of course, he made one down there when it was miserable, and so I thought he did a good job, you know, coming in and getting those 3 points.
You talk about the decision to go with Aaron as your holder.
Yeah.
Your thought process there.
You know, Aaron's got a lot of the reps, you know, and our other holder was under the weather with a flu the last 2 days. And so that was kind of part of it. But Aaron, you know, he gets reps every single Tuesday, and Carlson has confidence in him too.